Matty Askin is over here at the Collyhurst and Moston Gym in Manchester. You know the surroundings well. You trained here for quite a long time under Brian Hughes and Pat Barrett, didn't you?
Yeah, this is where I started my boxing career, where I turned over. There's full of talent in the gym like there is today. It's a good old-fashioned gym.
You trained here with Mike Jennings. Is that where you got to know Mike, and now he's your full-time trainer?
Yeah, you know, I parted ways with him for a while because I didn't really like him, but as he's matured a bit, he's turned into a good trainer, and I enjoy being around him.
And you're over here doing a sparring, getting ready for your next fight.
Sparring with Blaise, he's got 7 rounds in. He's a tough fella, you know, he makes me work every second of the round, which is good. You know, I'm hitting my stride now in the camp, starting to pick it up, and looking forward to putting a performance on up on October 22nd at the Macro.
Tell me about that fight. It's against Tommy McCarthy, the Belfast lad. He's a good fighter. It's going to be a good fight, but there's plenty on the line. It's worth it. It's British title eliminator.
Yeah, he's a good fighter. I went over and sparred him last year. He's, you know, he's awkward. He's I think he won silver or something in Commonwealth, or went to a Commonwealth or something. He's naturally talented kid, nice lad as well. So once we get in there, it's time to go to work on him, and I'm pretty confident in doing a job on him.
And if you do a job on him, you do get the win. Where does that leave you? Are you going for that British title then?
Yeah, the British, or we've had phone calls from Germany, you know, for a big fight against somebody, and hopefully we get this win, and whichever one comes first, really, you know. I think Oval's got a fight or defend against Kennedy. And then I get the winner of them. Well, I had to come through McCarthy.
And you know, after a long career, you could say now, you know, you've been a pro now, what, 10 years, is it?
10 years, right, yeah.
How are you feeling now in your career? How do you feel as a fighter, you know, physically, mentally?
I'm feeling a bit full as a fighter, you know. I probably turned over a little bit too early. I mean, I was 18. It was a bit rushed, I think. Now I'm 27, so you know, I've still got a bit of time really to push on now. And I think now I'm starting to really hit my peak, coming to, you know, being more manly in that ring, man strength, and like you say, mentally, I think I'm in the best place I've been for a long time.
You could see that part of your career almost for the first stage as a real learning curve. You've been in some hard fights you probably shouldn't have took at the time, fights.
Definitely. You know, that's exactly what it is. I mean, I went through a bit of a management crisis once Brian retired, and, you know, I probably took fights that were unnecessary, and they probably did me harm at the time as well. But, you know, now I've been able to sit back and look, you know, I've learned from it, and I've improved on it. And I think, you know, October 22nd, people will see a bigger difference from the last performance after stopping Simon Barclay as well. I had the tip to do well. I went in there and absolutely annihilated him. So, you know, I'm beginning to prove that I'm probably one of the best in Britain.
So this second stage of your career, if you like, all the ups and downs could stand you in good stead to give it a good push, and probably one of the most experienced cruiserweights in the country.
Yeah, definitely. And like I say, I'm still only probably one of the youngest as well. So, you know, I've got everything in my favour at the moment.
Good luck, Matty.
Thank you very much.